Hey everyone. Happy Tuesday. So I've been kind of hitting my head against a spelunky wall for the past couple weeks. And last night I felt like I kind of, let's just say I reached a certain point of frustration that I think I need to take a little break from. The streaming equivalent of taking a breath of fresh air and counting to 10. So this is Broken Age. This is the new Double Fine adventure game, or Act 1 of it. I'm only going to be doing half of what's currently in the game, since the game came out pretty recently and I don't want to, spoil everything. I will be spoiling all the puzzles and everything for Shay's story, which is one of the two playable characters. So if you think you're going to play this at some point in the future and you don't want to be spoiled, then I'd advise, looking away. If you're watching live, I'm going to be doing the Spelunky Daily when that rolls over at 7 p.m. my time, midnight UTC. Let me sync up the chat. That was not the right button. There we go. Okay, just a word of warning, this is a very dialogue-heavy game, so I won't be talking nearly as much as I normally do during these things. I'll chime in every now and then with, a bit of information or to answer a question or, whatever, but for the most part, I'll let the game do the talking. It should be a nice, relaxing experience, and if you like it, then I hope you go out and get the full game and get the full experience. I believe Act 2 comes out in April. At least that's what's scheduled. Who knows if they're actually going to be able to hit that. But, let's get started. That's Vela on the left, Shay on the right. I actually like Vela's story more than Shay's. A lot more fleshed out, I think. I like both of them a lot, but Vela's is my favorite of the two. So I'll be showing off. It's a good story, but if you like it, then I suggest getting the game so you can do the other story. Am I going to sync the chat for this? Yeah, I'm not sure if I'm going to put the chat log in the video or not. Since the subtitles might interfere with the subtitles in the game. I'm not really sure. I hear the game's super easy. Yeah, but that doesn't bother me.
Hey, rise and shine, son. You better get up. I'm almost off duty. Your mom's gonna be here soon, and you know how she is. Oops, here she comes. Have a great day, Shay.
There's my little angel.
Computer, snooze.
No more snoozies for my little spaceman this morning. Oh, I hope no bad tinkle fairies came and wet your bed during the night.
Computer, off.
Come on and get up, Shay. Lots of important adventures to go on today. Get up now, Mr. Man, or I'll turn on the mean sound. Okay, you asked for it.
I know that sound will get me out of bed. That's pretty brutal. I'm not sure if this is a joke or not, but Tim Schafer, the designer of the game, said that he received a lot of bug reports about this blanket. People saying that the texture is missing. And, clearly it's just a hollow blanket. Alright, I guess we'll get up.
Easy, computer.
Oh, quit being so shy. I used to change your diaper.
That's a great Jennifer Hale as the voice of the mom.
Choco Rockets.
Best known for her voice talents as Commander Shepard in Mass Effect. How do I feel about Chakra Rex today? Nah.
Yikes. No way.
Cinnamons.
I think I'd rather eat a bug.
Honey holograms.
That does sound pretty good. I do like honeygrams. And the holographic aspect just seals the deal.
Sounds good, computer. I wonder if this bowl is as sick of cereal as I am.
Can't wait to start Mission Nutrition. So just... Yes! You won't be sorry, Commander.
Oops, I cut the spoon off. Sorry, spoon.
Stay on alert. I think there might be food around.
Always, sir.
Half the fun of a game like this is seeing how different items interact with each other, so I'm probably going to be trying a bunch of stupid stuff with the inventory items. Which would be fun.
Once more into the Milky Breach! It's happening! It's really happening! Now, sir, I don't just serve food. I also serve up nutrition facts and eating encouragement. For instance, that last spoonful was exactly 7.1 calories. Did you? Commander? Aren't you excited to see what the big deal is? Up on the bridge? No? Well then, want to know the viscosity of this morning's synthetic milk?
Okay, computer. What's the big emergency?
I wish you'd call me Mom, sweetie.
I wish you called me Captain, computer.
Okay, Captain, sweetie. Let's get down to business. We are currently tracking multiple developing crises that need urgent attention. First of all, a massive avalanche has been reported on the planet Galactica. Second, there's a runaway train in System 7 that's headed for Spike Canyon. We've also received a Mayday signal from the vessel Friendship Circle. They're under attack. And, uh-oh, this just came in. My sensors are reporting an entity of unknown origin has attached itself to the hull of this very ship. What are your orders, Captain?
Well, that avalanche sounds pretty urgent. I think that's a crisis that requires our immediate attention. A foreign body, that sounds like it could be dangerous, but it doesn't seem to be impacting the integrity of the hull for now, so I'll check that out in a bit.
We need to help those avalanche victims.
I knew you'd want to help them, sweetie. Plotting a course for Planet Galactica.
Help! Help! Someone help us! My toes are really chilly!
This is the massive avalanche?
It's worse than it looks!
Really? How? That's not worse.
By the way, if Shay sounds kind of like a hobbit, that's because that is Elijah Wood doing the voice. Who's supposedly a big adventure game fan, from what I hear. Alright, let's check out our surroundings
hey,
here.
Check this out.
Why not check out us avalanche victims over here instead? Please, I'd like those tolerant.
Discovered a strange feature over here, computer.
Just ignore that, Shay.
Very curious. Alright, I guess I'll help these guys out. What do you want from me?
Don't worry. I'll figure out how to get you out of there soon.
We know you will. We believe in you, Shay!
Alright, well, this is a tricky puzzle. It's a good thing I brought the spoon with me for some reason.
Good job!
Special nutrition paste for you today. Oh, not sure what this one is. Ready for your next exciting space mission, honey? We've got an avalanche, a runaway train, a spaceship under attack, and a mysterious object on the hull.
Man, that was a lot of ice cream. I don't think he would have been able to eat all that. And survive. I don't know. Okay, sounds like it's time to check out that foreign body. It sounds pretty dangerous.
Better suit up and investigate that foreign body.
Ooh, I don't like you going out there. Let's use the safety suit.
Ah, come on.
The scarf's the most important part, by the way.
Okay, I'm outside the ship. The foreign body must be very close by.
Man, forget this. I'm going into space.
Woo!
Aw. Alright. Anything else over this way? Doesn't look like it. Heck is that thing?
I found the object. It appears to be something organic in nature. Something's telling me I should stick my face right into it.
Ah! Get off of me! Get off!
You're going to love this dinner pill. Deep fried nutrition paste.
I try to get as much nutrition as possible deep fried. Well, wait, I want to see what was in that present. I guess I can't do that yet. Okay, let's see what's going on with the friendship circle.
We have to defend the friendship circle.
Oh, I just don't know who would attack those poor defenseless cuties. To the teleporter room.
I'm aboard the distressed vessel, Friendship Circle. I found one of the crew.
Rule number one, always investigate other things first.
Controls. What a surprise. More fake controls. Fake controls. What a surprise. I wouldn't sit in those beanbag chairs.
Why not? They look comfy.
More fake controls.
Oh, right, my present. What did I get? Wait, I want to examine.
Come on. Puppy. Oh, look. It's another Grab and Gary robot. Can't wait to put it in the trash. I mean, my collection. Come on, Grab and Gary. Be more fun. You can do it. Can't you do anything except grab stuff? Gary doesn't give hugs. Gary likes grabbing controls, but not fake ones.
All right. What's your problem?
What happened here? From an enemy vessel? Or an alien creature? Or did you attack yourselves in a fit of space madness?
It was a...
Yes?
Attack!
So brave, but you're still my precious little baby captain.
Good night, son. See you tonight, son.
So much to do today. Come on, sweetie. Chuckle rockets?
Nah.
Yikes. No way.
Cinnamons.
I think I'd rather eat a bug.
Honey holograms.
No thanks, computer.
Nebulumps?
Yuck. You know I hate that.
Soylent Dreams.
No, not in that kind of mood today.
Crispy bunches of space.
Man, that sounds horrible.
Brain blasters?
Ugh, take that away.
Strawberry comet trails.
Please, don't take this personally, but no thanks.
Whole grain nutrient paste?
Are you kidding? Gross.
You eat munch.
Yuck. Are you even trying, computer?
Galactic slime?
I think I'm allergic to that, aren't I?
Splarg?
Best line in the game.
Really? Splarg? Is it my birthday or something?
According to Tim Schafer.
Your saliva has a 0.001 pH imbalance today. May I suggest more whole grain nutrient paste?
What mission should we go on next, sweetie?
Let's see. I've done all of these except this one. Let's see what that runaway train's all about.
Let's catch that runaway train.
Aye, aye, Captain Sweetie. To System 7.
Hey, I'm a heroic genius.
Wake up, bridge man!
Finally! My arms were about to pop up! Thank you, brave hero! We celebrate! Thank you! So great!
Absolutely not.
Aww. I ran out of time to do the wave.
Thanks for keeping it safe.
Got a special nutrition paste for you today. Space meat in a blanket. What mission should we go on next, sweetie?
Ugh, I gotta get out of this routine.
Damn, I feel like I missed out on a real opportunity there.
Fake train wreck, please.
I knew you choose that one. To System 7.
Wake up, bridge man!
Great! Now don't do anything else! I'm going to let go!
I think it's time we break out of this routine. Oh, what the hell? I clicked off of it by mistake. You can hit space to skip cutscenes, if you've already seen them, by the way.
You're going to love this dinner pill. Brussels sprouts.
Well, at least we get to try all these other great dinners.
What should we go on next, sweetie?
Here we go again. Fake train wreck, please.
Let's try this one more time.
That
to System 7.
We're gonna crash into Spike!
Wake up, Bridge Man!
We're saved! He fell off the bridge!
Back to sleep, Bridge Man.
Son, what are you doing? That's not right.
Wake up, Bridge Man!
We're saved!
Boy, that was close. What the hell? I clicked yes. That was weird. I actually didn't do this the last time I played through the game. I went another route. I guess I have to do that again.
Time for the hero to close his little hero eyes.
Hey, any day without a real emergency is a good day, son.
It's really cool that they wrote all this incidental dialogue.
See you tonight, son.
So much to do today. Come on, sweetie.
Just in case you have to end up redoing these. Yeah, that sounds good. Well, I never cycled through all the cereals. Let's see what comes after Splarg.
I think I'd rather eat a bug.
Honey holograms.
No thanks. Yeah. No. Man. Ugh. Please. Are you kidding? Yuck. I think I'm.
Alright, what could possibly be better than Splarg?
Splarg? Seriously? Are you trying to make me unplug you, computer?
Oh, come on! You love Splarg!
Oh, dang. Oh well.
Choking is not delicious.
What mission should we go on next, sweetie?
I'd rather jump off a cliff than do this again.
I think there might be a hint.
Fake train wreck, please.
I knew you'd choose that one. To System 7.
We're gonna crash into Spike Canyon!
Wake up, Bridge Man!
We're safe!
The first time I played, I actually did this just to see what would happen.
Back to sleep, Bridge.
So I wanted to see what would happen if I didn't.
Having fun? Huh? Who are you? When you tire of child's play, when you're ready for real danger, come see me.
But...
Tell no one. Do you understand?
Okay. But...
No one.
Hey! Wait!
What?
No discussion about it, young man. You need to rest and heal up in bed until further notice.
Computer, I'm fine. Obviously.
No, you might have a delayed fracture. That can happen.
No, it can't.
All missions are canceled. I love you.
I don't remember the name of the guy who voices the wolf, but he has a really, really excellent creepy voice.
Weird. No missions. I can do whatever? It looks like a weird little screwdriver.
It does? Oh, does Gary want to grab it?
Come on, Grab and Gary. Be more fun. You can do it. Can't you do anything except grab stuff?
Guess not.
Missions canceled until further notice. Whoops. It's a tank of compressed air. Could be useful in an emergency. It's a tank of compressed air.
Same thing.
Could be useful in an emergency. Missions canceled until further notice. Whoops. The air vent is screwed shut with these weird little screws.
Oh, what a coincidence. I have a weird little screwdriver.
It works. What's this? It looks like an inflatable raft. It's a tank of compressed air. Could be useful in an emergency. Yeah, right. Like we have those. It's a tank of compressed air. Could be
some of the UI elements are a little fiddly in this game.
Like we have. Maybe this air tank has enough pressure to blow up this raft. Whoa. It looks like a blow-up doll of me. Creepy.
Like, you have to click exactly, like, if I want these two objects to interact, you have to make sure it's a little plus symbol and not a little magnifying glass.
It's a tank of compressed air.
It's not that big a deal.
Could be useful.
I guess those two items don't interact.
Yeah, right. Like, we have those. No. Gary worries his sharp embrace might be lethal to little lazy me.
That's true.
Hopefully, this looks enough like me to fool the warden. Why do computers need sleep?
To dream of electric sheep, of course.
Negative. This door is locked.
Creepy.
Where's my little angel? Oh, there he is. Oh, I think I almost lost you today. Sleep tight, little hero.
Man, computers are stupid.
Man, don't talk about your mom like that. That's not cool. Didn't you listen to Mr. T? Probably not.
Whoa. How have I never seen this part of the ship before?
You came because you are done with children's games.
Yes. Who are you?
My name is Marek, and what I'm about to show you is no game. While you've been drifting through the universe, eating ice cream, playing with trains, war has been raging across the galaxy.
War? Between who?
Between the forces that every war is between. Between the powerful and the weak. The tyrants and the innocent.
But who?
Does it even matter? There will always be war.
War never changes.
We cannot start it, and we cannot stop it. What we can do is protect the weak and rescue the helpless. Look at this distress signal I just received from a peaceful colony in the Talon Nebula. The helpless creatures you see have been imprisoned by forces of tyranny and may soon be executed.
But...
Yes?
We have to save them.
Yes. Yes, we do. I'm pleased you feel as such.
We have to go tell the ship's computer.
No. You must tell no one on this ship what I have just told you. This ship is programmed with one function. To keep you safe.
Yeah, I noticed that.
To help these creatures, you will need to put yourself at risk in a way she could never understand.
No, you're right. She would never understand. So what can we do?
First, we have to get to the Talon Nebula. Take this star chart to the navigation room. I have an earpiece for you to wear so we can stay in contact. Use that vent to avoid detection. Return immediately after you're successful. But quickly, young cop, we don't have much time.
I think I'd be a little more skeptical of all this than Shay is being. Seems a little out of the blue.
Those poor creatures.
They're counting on you, young Cobb.
Excuse me, Merrick?
What are you doing? There's no time to waste. Take that vent to the navigation room and give that star chart to the Space Weaver right now.
Alright, pushy. Hey, what's this thing?
Time to save some helpless creatures.
Do not touch those until I tell you that it's time. I apologize. It's just that I build them myself and I'm a little protective.
It's cool, Merrick. Hey, what's in here?
The store is locked.
This is a stealth mission. Not safe to use the hallways, understand?
You can double click.
The young master has come to play with the Space Weaver. Where shall we go today, wise commander?
Oh man, a real mission for once. This is so fun.
This is serious, Shay. Stay focused.
You can hear everything I say?
Yes. Please don't say anything embarrassing.
You can double click when you have an exit arrow to quickly travel from one area to the next. Except I can't go this way.
This door is locked.
The Space Weaver is Richard Horowitz, the voice of the main character of Psychonauts and Invader Zim.
Hey, Space Weaver, let's go somewhere exciting for a change.
I have been programmed to take the young master wherever he desires, as long as it is safe and free of conflict.
Aww.
Bring me a star chart. And the fabric of time and space shall be knit to serve your passage.
Hey, I have one of those.
This is the star chart for Talon Nebula. Hey, Space Weaver, can you take me here?
That is an easy one for the Space Weaver. Prepare the decryption mechanism.
See this thing in action.
Looks like the Space Weaver has encoded the star chart into a graph of nuts and pearls.
Spindle at rotational velocity.
Looks like the Space Weaver has encoded the star chart into a graph of nuts and pearls.
4, 3, 2, 1 Just doing my job.
If I give the Space Weaver a star chart, he'll weave the destination pattern into this nav scarf.
Good job, Space Weaver.
Hey, Space Weaver, let's go somewhere exciting for a change.
I have been programmed to take the young master.
All right, we saw that. Okay, Merrick, now what?
We should be in the Talon Nebula now.
Great work, young Cobb. We're approaching the location of the distress signal now. This is worse than I thought. The good news is their captors have left them unguarded for the time being.
What can I do?
Here, take these controls. You need to lower the shields so the boom arms can be extended. Good. Now wait until the boom arm is correctly positioned above the subject, then press this to engage the grappling sequence.
Alright, finally some action.
Careful. Wait for it.
Gotcha, you thing.
I got it!
Great work, Shay. Now the boom arms will haul it in and place it in the auxiliary cargo hold.
I should go see if it's okay.
No. They must remain in complete quarantine for their own protection. And ours.
You mean, our diseases might kill them?
You are wise for such a young cop. Now we must save more, quickly, before their captors return. Use the movement controls to position the ship. go on. Move the ship. Careful. Wait for it.
Got another one.
Great. Now just place it in the cargo hold and... Oh no.
What is it?
Hostile forces have been detected nearby. They're coming in our direction. We need to retreat.
Not yet. There's still one more to save.
No time. We have to pull out immediately or we'll be destroyed.
No!
You didn't tell me I'd have to pick who lived and died.
You want to be a grown-up? Get used to making tough decisions. No time to mourn. There's another distress signal. This one's from Danger System 5. Are you up to it? Shay, are you the master of your feelings or are they the master of you?
Give me the star chart.
I don't know. Danger System 5. Sounds dangerous.
Time to save some helpless creatures.
Do not touch those until I tell you that it's time. I apologize. It's just that I build them myself and I'm a little protective.
So, like, what's your deal anyway, dude?
Excuse me, Merrick?
What are you doing? There's no time to waste. Take that vent to the navigation room and give that star chart to the Space Weaver right now.
Don't want to talk? Okay, that's cool.
Hey, Space Weaver, let's go somewhere exciting for a change.
I have been programmed to take the young...
Right. Here's the star chart.
Hey, Space Weaver, can you take me here?
With pleasure. Preparing decryption mechanism. Initializing warp and wolf drive. Intake calipers in position. Weave thrusters at viscosity. Spindle at rotational velocity.
Looks like the Space Weaver has encoded the star chart into a graph of knits and curves.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Science.
And we're here. Please enjoy your stay and be safe.
Okay, we should be in Danger System 5.
Are we ever? Take a look at this.
Okay, lower shields.
Careful.
Deploy grabby thing.
Wait for it.
Excellent. Securing subject and cargo hold.
Don't wait forever, though.
Great work.
Good. But hurry, we're running out of time.
Well, only two more. We should be able to get them. Oh crap, this one's moving.
Just push the button.
Boy, that was close.
Okay, that's enough.
What do you mean, that's enough?
I mean, enemy ships are approaching.
I don't see anything. I need to save this last one.
You're going to endanger the whole mission to save one creature?
Just give me a second.
You know,
this is a waste of
time. I really don't trust this Merrick dude.
There is no need for this.
I don't think he's being forthright.
It's just...
Aw, man, really?
Dang. Enemy ships are getting closer every...
Okay, I got it. But something's wrong.
Cut it loose. We need to retreat before...
Attention! Ship is under attack.
What happened?
Probably one of the enemy vessels I warned you about, remember?
We need to get that last creature.
Too late. The ship is retreating under autopilot to a safe location. And we're completely locked out of the controls.
Yeah. How are we going to perform any more rescues?
We'll have to find another way to hack into the boom arm controls. and another way to bring the shields down at the right time. And who knows if we'll be able to navigate to the right system now that the ship's on high alert.
The ship's computer must be freaking out right now.
Oh, yes. As soon as the alarm sounded, the first thing she probably did was check on you and your...
Shay! Shay! Are you hurt? Oh, thank goodness. Don't worry, sweetie. Something attacked the ship, but Mommy's taking care of it. Nothing to worry about, okay? Oh, so brave.
Whew. Better get back to Merrick to hear his plan. I've tried throwing a towel over that thing, but she always pulls it off. Just once, I'd like to see a huge flaming asteroid hurtling in our direction.
Well, that would be pretty cool.
Ship under attack. Everything's fine. Well, you're half right.
Young cop, you must come see me right away. Another distress signal has arrived.
Aw, man. That dude's as bad as Mom. Fine, okay, mysterious wolf creature.
Any luck?
No. Still locked out of the controls.
Any luck with the ship's controls?
No, but we intercepted a new distress signal, this time from Prima Doom.
The distress call was from Prima Doom? How do we get there?
Same as always. Take this star chart to the Space Weaver and hope for the best.
Can you tell me how we get to Prima Doom again?
Take that star chart I gave you to the Space Weaver.
Right, the star chart.
Oh, sorry. I have a really bad memory.
How are we going to get control of the ship's cargo boom arms?
We'll need to attempt a manual override. The manual boom arm controls are located here. You can get to them through the ship's airlock here. I've hacked the airlock door so you can now open it without alerting the Overmother.
Or the Ubermother, as she likes to be called sometimes.
How are we going to take down the shields?
I have a plan. The shields require so much power, they have a dedicated source. This fusion orb. Take this Omicron inhibitor and place it over the fusion orb. And when the time is right, we'll turn it on and turn off the fusion orb.
Along with the ship's shields. Got it. So, how long have you been living in here?
I am a recent stowaway. I came because I sensed you were ready.
Are you really a wolf?
No, I wear this disguise to blend in with your... other stuffed animal friends.
Weird. So that's a wolf suit? What are you underneath?
I am what I do. A rescuer of creatures in need. Just like you.
Why do I have to be the one to choose who to rescue?
A boy your age just has good instincts for the job.
Sorry, Bippo. I know this isn't the most exciting game in the world, but, you know, it's relaxing, which is kind of why I chose it. Nice, intermission from Spelunky.
I'd better get back to the mission.
Yes, our window of opportunity won't last forever.
Alright.
Merrick.
Anything else to say? Nah.
I'd better get back to the mission.
Yes, our window of opportunity won't last forever.
Alright, first things first, I guess, head to this Prima Doom place. Oh, wait.
This is the star chart for Prima Doom. This is Merrick's defibrillator.
Inhibitor?
Right. And I need to put it on the confusion ball.
Fusion orb... Wait, are you doing this on purpose?
Aw. I want to wear it.
I don't need any more inhibiting.
Okay.
We need to go here right away. Prima doom!
Negative. That system is forbidden due to likelihood of hostile activity.
But it's an emergency.
Sometimes, safety is the most exciting adventure of all. Might I suggest somewhere safer? Like Puppy Planetoid, Cozy Cluster, or maybe somewhere in the Smile system?
No way. I have to go to Prima Doom right now. Lives depend on it.
I'm sorry, young master, but my programming won't allow it.
I like the sound of Puppy Planetoid.
All right. Let's try Puppy Planetoid.
Preparing decryption mechanism. Initializing warp and wolf drive.
Woof drive.
Looks like the Space Weaver has encoded the star chart into a graph of knots and pearls.
Spindle at rotational velocity. Deploying nav scarf in 5. 4.
Hey, Just Rot. Yeah, it's an adventure game.
2. 1.
I needed a break from the stress of Spelunky. Just for a couple hours. Man, that's the most adorable planetoid I've ever seen.
A cute little planetoid. I'll give it that.
See? Shay agrees. Alright, Merrick, you won't take me to Prima Doom. Now what?
Merrick. The Space Weaver won't make a nav scarf for Prima Doom.
How are your knitting skills?
Non-existent.
I'd better get back to the mission.
Yes. Our window of opportunity won't last forever.
Alright, well, let's scout around then. Can I go in here yet? Awesome.
The helpless creatures we rescued are being quarantined in there. Wish I could let them out. But it's for their own safety, I guess. Judging by the wolf hair, this must be where Merrick sleeps.
I don't see any wolf hair. Looks cozy, though.
Hey, the helmet comes off. Ah, my first hazard suit. Kept out Omicron radiation, and kept in diaper leaks.
Hello, Marptic. I agree. Oh, oops.
Ah, my first hazard suit, man. How tiny was I when I used to wear this radiation helmet? It's sealed shut. I think she had it bronzed. I couldn't even wear it as a glove if I wanted to. Man, how tiny was I when I used to wear this radiation helmet? She bronzed my first space shoes. Or is that the remains of my old bomb squad bot? I wish she'd get rid of these. My papier-mâché is so much better than that now. I made a hexi-pal out of a paper plate. Probably thought they were alive then. Wonder what's in those creepy jars. My old teeth? Hair? I never want to see another train as long as I live. I gave up making art years ago. And if no one's around to see it, who cares? As soon as we get full control of this ship, I'm going to burn this stuff.
And, of course, my Oscar.
That should be for acting. Acting like I cared about the stupid missions on this ship. Teleporter, activate.
May I teleport you to the Nexus?
Where am I from? The United States. West Virginia.
Oh, this is the best part of my day.
Hey,
My head.
What's wrong?
My head is smaller.
Yeah, you just used a teleporter.
Why did my head shrink?
Quantum physics. Duh. Don't worry, I'll come back to normal when you take the trip back through me, big baby.
I just love how condescending the teleporter is. It's like, yeah, obviously, you used a teleporter. I bet I can wear this helmet now.
Man, how tiny was I when I used to wear this
guess not. Do I have to put it on my head?
Man,
nope. Hold on.
How tiny was I when I used to wear this radiation?
Alright, let's see. What are my options here?
Teleporter, activate.
This way to the fusion ore containment facility.
Oh, that's one of my goals, right?
There is no time.
Have I ever been to Europe or Sweden? Nope, neither. I'd like to, though.
Okay, now my head is just getting ridiculous.
Oh boy, you went through two teleporters without a return trip, didn't you? You're playing with fire, kid.
Now I can wear the helmet, right?
Man, how tiny was I when I used to wear this radiation helmet?
Caution, entering an area of strong Omicron radiation levels. Full radiation shielding necessary to proceed.
Lay it on me.
Hey, his voice wasn't high-pitched there.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Looks like a Power Ranger suit.
Hey, where's my helmet? That's just great.
Inconsistency with the voice pitch. That kind of sucks. Oh well, everything else about this game is so polished. Can forgive a tiny little mistake like that.
My head is almost small enough to fit in this helmet now. I'm not getting any closer to that fusion orb without my radiation helmet. Boiling my brain is not the kind of danger I'm looking for.
Well, now what? Well, let's see. I need to make my head one size smaller. How do I go about doing that?
Teleporter, activate.
May I teleport you to the Nexus? Oh, this is the best part of my day.
It must be pretty awesome being an elevator.
See you.
Teleporter, activate.
To the starboard passageway, sir. Not responsible for lost items, motion sickness, or mutations. All there, great.
Man, I wish I could talk to these robot things. Oh, what's over here?
Warning, airlock ahead. Safety suit and air tether required for extra vehicular exploration.
But don't worry, I'll put it on you, sweetie pie. Ugh.
Whoa. I don't remember those things. Alright, well, while I'm out here, I do need to mess with the ship's boom arms. Don't think I can get there yet, though. You have another present for me?
Open up. But this time, take it easy.
It didn't take it easy.
Giving back presents is rude.
It's very true.
I wonder if I could attach this to my helmet somehow for a little air to go.
It's a good idea.
Let's see if this fits. Come on. That's the stuff.
Well, I've solved my air problem.
Here we go! Man.
But I still have the tether. If only I could cut it somehow. Gary?
If only I had a slice and Sally instead of a grab and Gary.
I could be free. No offense, Gary. I don't want to get space mucus on Merrick's inebriator.
Inhibitor. Fusion orb inhibitor.
Well, crud. I don't think there's anything else I can do here.
That would be a really slow way to cut it.
That's true. Alright, back into the ship. I think the last point-and-click puzzle games I played were Been There, Damn That, and Time, Gentlemen, Please. Names sound familiar. I don't really know anything about them, though. Last point-and-click adventure game I played, besides this, was Strong Bad's Cool Game for Attractive People. The Homestar Runner adventure game. Well, no, that's not true, if you count The Walking Dead. But it's really more of a dialogue game than a puzzle game, really. There aren't really that many puzzles to be found in it. I know I said I didn't want to see another train, but... I love the little puppeteers.
Can't I ride the train again?
Band for life.
Well, that guy seems pretty serious. Oh wait, there was something I didn't interact with in there.
Warning. Objects placed into this trash chute will be jettisoned from the ship, and the next time it happens to one of your toys, Shay, your father is not going to retrieve it for you. You crawl into something once when you're 2 years old, and they lock it forever.
I don't see anything I want to dispose of. I should probably keep most of the stuff.
This tiny suit wouldn't be much use there, or anywhere.
It's true. Oh, hey, it's this place again. What's the matter, little buddy?
Fake controls. What a surprise. Hey, missions are canceled. You can drop the act. Hey, I didn't attack you. You guys attacked me.
Is that what you came down here for? To point fingers?
Hey, maybe I can fix your back.
Really?
Yeah, I think I see what's wrong. Hold still.
Yes! That feels amazing!
You're welcome.
I don't think we need to do that mission again.
Well, I gotta go.
See ya!
Triforce is on the beanbag back here.
I wouldn't sit in those beanbag chairs.
Or,
they'd cuddle me.
Hey! Don't knock until you try it!
More fake controls. Fake controls. What a surprise. More fake controls.
Trying to trigger a bit of dialogue. Might not be here, though.
Fake controls. What a surprise. More fake controls.
Nope, guess not. Okay, well, I think I can use this hook to solve one of my dilemmas. Let's see what it says.
I wonder if I could knit with this.
Actually, it's a crochet hook, so you could probably crochet with it.
Wow. You know a lot about yarn crafts.
Wolf costumes don't make themselves.
Yeah, I could go for some ice cream.
Hey, guys.
I suppose you want to ride the Avalanche Mission Protocol. Hey, we're supposed to be on break.
Nope, I just wanted to see what you guys were up to.
Not much. You know, just chilling. He's been waiting for you. waiting for you to ask back for a long time.
Man, I want to play cards with those guys.
It's a whipped cream gum. And it's mine. Warning. Contains artificial sweeteners suspended in a powerful propellant. Do not discharge into eyes. When the candy and treats are all you can eat 24/7, they just aren't that appetizing anymore.
Oh, this kid's got some real tough problems.
It reminds me of a sketch from that Mitchell and Webb look, where David Mitchell works as an ice cream taster. Or maybe it's the other way around. One of them works as an ice cream taster, and the other one, like, deals with sick orphans all the day or something. And, you know, David Mitchell comes home from his ice cream tasting job and just complains about, you know, how tough it is. And in retrospect, it doesn't really seem like that big of a deal. Can I still eat this stuff?
Might as well dig in.
Actually, that stuff is fake. Yeah, don't eat it. It's made of reconstituted yarn waste.
Ew.
Son, I'm not sure it's safe enough for you to leave your room.
I'm tired of being a prisoner in my room. I'm sick of being a prisoner on this ship.
I know, son. I know it's hard. You've given up so much. Listen, I'd like to tell you a story. A story of another person your age, a young girl. She wanted to live a normal life, but she was chosen. She was honored with a special duty. Some people would call it a sacrifice, but what she didn't realize at the time was that it was a great honor.
Please. I've heard the story of the Sacrifice Girl a million times. I know the ending. The Sacrifice Girl is you, right?
What I'm trying to tell you is that I made a hard choice, but I regret nothing because...
Great story, computer. I'm sorry they programmed you with someone's sad memories, but I have to go.
You know the truth deep down, son. And I know you'll appreciate my words someday.
Uh-huh. Brother.
Man, he's so mean to his mom. She's so nice. I feel bad.
Yes, my love.
Is there anybody else on this ship?
It's just you, me, and your father, of course. Oh, are you feeling lonely? I could knit you some new friends.
So, you've never seen a strange wolf around?
Son, I can't keep track of all your yarn pals. Oh, are you saying you'd like a little wolf friend? Well, I've never knit a wolf before, but it should be no problem.
So what does Dad do during the day?
Oh, your father has a lot of work to do outside, you know? Fixing the hull, scraping off space parasites, keeping a lookout for new planets to live on.
Computer, were you aware that the universe was at war? And that helpless creatures are being terrorized by ruthless tyrants?
Ooh, that sounds like a fun new game. I'll talk to the Yarn Pals and get that set up for the next round of missions. Would you like that?
Never mind. Computer, what's the point of all this?
Son, you know how important Operation Dandelion is. Our home, Laruna, was dying. So we set sail in the Bassa Nostra to travel the universe and find you a new home.
Why haven't we found a new home yet?
Well, the universe is a big place, and it has to be perfect for my baby.
Computer, we need to get to Prima Doom immediately.
Absolutely not. They call it Prima Doom for a reason. Why not have some fun in a smile system instead?
Well, I gotta get back to taking over the ship.
Oh, sweetie, you're so funny.
Are we even allowed in the Forbidden Zone? Not sure about that.
Fake. Fake. Totally fake. I can't believe I used to think these were real. Some of these have teeth marks on them. The squeaky sound should have tipped me off. Wait, this one's real? No, fake. They're all super fake.
Well, dang. That's the dialogue I was trying to get in the other room. Let's see, that's the Space Weaver's room. What do we have going on in here?
Don't you have anything else to do?
Just making sure you're safe.
Emergency rations? I think that's overreacting. Not going back in there if I can help it. Can't believe she'd leave something this dangerous lying around.
What's that?
Nothing.
You call that a knife?
You don't talk too, do you?
Not unless I have something to say.
Please ignore him, sir. Bad attitude.
A sassy New Jersey knife.
Hey,
makes sense.
Why won't this open?
Oh, honey, you can't come in here. I'm working on a surprise for you.
What is it?
Nice try.
I want a surprise. Well, let's see. I could take a nap.
Can't sleep. On a mission.
Oh, that's true. Well, alright, let's talk to that Space Weaver again. Man. Okay, looks like he's up to something. That robot climbing up the window. Hey, dude.
We need to go here right away. Prima Doom!
Negative. That system is forbidden due to likelihood of hostile activity.
But it's an emergency.
Sometimes, safety is the most exciting adventure of all. Might I suggest somewhere safer? Like Puppy Planetoid, Cozy Cluster, or maybe somewhere in the Smile System?
Nah, I tried Puppy Planetoid. That place didn't seem that great.
Well, it is a cute little planetoid. I'll give it that.
I mean, cuteness aside.
This is the star chart for Prima Doom.
Alright, I think I can whip something up here.
Where shall we go today, Wise Commander?
Maybe the smile system would be better.
I don't think this will work.
This is the star chart for Prima Doom.
No.
Looks like the Space Weaver has encoded the star chart into a graph. I wonder if I could knit with this.
Actually, it's a crochet.
Shut up.
There's already a stitch there. I can't take it out.
Yeah.
I don't think anyone would mind.
You can't alter.
Let me just make one small change.
Existing stitches. Just add to it.
Not sure how that happened, sir. Where shall we go today,
Wise? Well, smile system didn't work out. Let's try the cozy cluster.
Cozy cluster it is.
This one might work.
Preparing decryption mechanism. Initializing warp and wolf drive.
This is the star chart for Prima Doom.
Intake calipers in position. Weave thrusters at viscosity.
Alright. Crap, what was it? Oh man. Oh, you can't undo the stitches you put in either. Crap, I messed up. This is the right one though.
Oh my. I seem to have made an error in my knitting.
Alright, let's try that again. Cozy cluster.
Cozy cluster it is.
Let's get in the screen first. Bring up the star chart. Alright, all three in the middle, two at the top. Okay. I got this. Oh, wait. Is it these three? Yeah.
Slight alteration here.
Pretty sure that's right. Yeah. Oh, wait. Crap. This one. Nope.
Oh, my.
All right, Weaver. One more try. Sorry.
Where shall we go today? We're not sure how that happens, sir.
Cozy cluster of
air. Preparing decryption mechanism.
All right, now I got it.
Initializing warp and wolf drive. Intake calibers.
So those, and that.
This is the star chart for Prima Doom.
Looking good.
In 5. 4. 3. 2, 1. Wait, no! This is not the destination I indicated. I'm so sorry, young master. I will correct this right. What's that? I seem to be out of yarn. Humiliation!
Wow, he took that really hard. Don't worry, Space Weaver. As soon as I rescue those helpless creatures, we'll get out of Prima Doom.
I know that
I
feeling.
Wake him till we're out of Prima Doom. He'll just freak out again.
How did I get that tool? It was in the room with the hug attack. You have to go back in there again. It's the crochet hook is stuck in the back of one of those yarn creatures. All right, well, we're in Prima Doom. What now?
Merit. So, we're in Prima Doom now, right?
Yes, good work. I've located the creatures in distress. Now, we must quickly get control of the cargo boom arms and disable those shields so we may rescue them. Quickly. We can't remain in this dangerous system for long.
I can't get the fusion orb without a radiation helmet.
You'll need to find some way to protect your head.
Or protect your neck.
The manual boom controls are beyond the reach of my air tether.
You're going to need to extend your range somehow.
I'd better get back to the mission.
Yes. Our window of opportunity won't last forever.
I feel kind of silly walking around with such a tiny head. I should probably take care of that. Not that way. Let's, oops. What the heck is this thing for, anyway?
Contains artificial sweeteners suspended in a powerful propellant. Do not discharge into eyes.
Hey, what are you trying to do?
Teleport?
You already went through me, but you didn't teleport back through me.
So?
So, your head is still messed up. You can't go through again, or it will get worse. You have to teleport back through me the other way, so your head goes back to normal size.
So many rules on this ship.
Your head is more important than you realize, Shay.
Apparently you need a head to live. Okay, well, let's try a different tack.
Wait, young cub. It is not time to deploy the rescue system yet.
Man, I want some action. Alright, that's a surprise room. Can't go in there yet. This is the teleporter room, right?
To the Nexus.
Not sure how this will affect my head.
No malfunction.
techno malfunction.
All there, great.
Went back to normal size. That sucks. The other teleporter wouldn't let me through it.
Goodbye.
No, that's the airlock. Maybe my head's already small enough. I guess I should just go ahead and try this. Or wait. I can't get there from here, can I?
Teleporter.
Oh, this is the best part of my day. There you are.
Teleporter, activate.
This way to the fusion orb containment facility. Whee! See you.
I think my head's still too big. I don't know, is it possible to get back to the Nexus without teleporting? I forget how I did this.
I think this machine is just never going to give me a helmet. What a ripoff. My head is almost small enough to fit in this helmet now.
I actually forget how I did this. That's weird.
There you are.
Wait, what's this way? Oh, okay. I can see. I get it. Didn't realize the Nexus was so close to this area.
Teleporter, activate.
May I teleport you to the Nexus?
All right, this should do the trick.
Hang on! Thanks for traveling with us.
Teleporter, activate.
This way. Oh, this is the best part of my day.
I think that's all my head can take.
You need to make a return trip through me right away, Shay.
In a minute.
I think I kind of stumbled on that sequence of events the first time I played.
Caution, entering an area of strong Omicron radiation levels. Full radiation shielding necessary to proceed.
I think this machine is just never going to give me a
voice back to normal.
What a ripoff.
Alright, now I bet this helmet will fit me.
A little snug, but I think it will work. I'm not sure how long I can stand the spoiled milk smell, though.
So yeah, Power Rangers Cyclops.
Gotta keep this thing on ice so it doesn't cause a meltdown, I guess.
Alright, time to contain that orb.
Easy does it. There. Fusion orb. Inhibitor.
Not quite. We won't activate the Omicron inhibitor until we're ready to take the shields down.
And when will we be ready?
As soon as you get us in control of those boom arms again.
Right.
Alright, just one more step. Okay, how do I take the helmet off? Oh, here we go.
Man, how tiny was I when I used to wear this radiation helmet?
Nope. Oh well, I'll just go back through. It should be fine.
Activate.
May I teleport you to the Nexus?
No malfunction.
Ow, 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 ow! Oh!
Head normalization expedited. You're welcome.
I hate quantum physics.
Oh, no. It turns out that whole head shrinking thing was just faulty wiring. One more trip and that head would pop right off. So again, you're welcome.
Man, that elevator was so sure of itself. In regards to the quantum physics.
Activate.
To the starboard passageway, sir.
All right, time for a little spacewalk. We have a knife. Might as well use it.
Here we go. Oh no. Gotta get further out. Come on, legs. Ugh. I wish I had some sort of propulsion.
Oh yeah. So that's what the whipped cream thing is for. All right. Curse you!
I'm free! In space!
Awesome.
Okay. Now what?
This game's so beautiful. I haven't really talked about it that much, but I just absolutely love the way this game looks. The animation and the art and everything is just freaking fantastic.
Those must be the manual controls for the boom arms. Maybe if I could get this hatch open. No good. Stupid fat hands.
All right, knife. Got one more job for you.
Let me try to... Oh, hey! Uh-oh! No, not the face! Or the neck! Or the body!
I'm free! Free to cleave the infinite void of space itself!
Phew. That's a relief for a lot of reasons. I think Gary wants to grab that. Okay, grabbing Gary. It's hero time. Don't be scared. Well, go ahead. Grab the controls. Oh, yeah, I have the button. Engage! Good boy! Oh, hey! That's enough, Gary. We don't want to attract attention just yet. You sit tight here, and I'll push the button again when it's go time, okay?
Man, it's a good thing I found that.
I don't want to activate Gary until it's time for the mission.
Whoa, his mouth looked weird.
I don't want to activate Gary until it's time for the mission.
It was like a Ren and Stimpy mouth. Anywhere else I can go?
Hi, Gary. You were the best present ever.
In the infinite void of space.
Those must be the ship's cargo boom arms. Man, those things are huge.
Nope, not really. Man, I want to go to space. That'd be so awesome. Alright, my work here is done.
Warning,
Airlock ahead. Safety suit and air tether required for extra vehicular exploration. But don't worry, I'll put it on you, sweetie pie. Ugh.
I love that. I love the mom in this game. She's awesome. One of the best characters. Alright, well, Merrick, I believe I've done everything you've asked me to.
Hey, Mom. Else to do?
Just making sure you're safe.
Oh yeah. I don't need to be in here. Weaver's still conked out.
Okay, I'll admit it. Prima Doom does look kinda dangerous, but in a good way.
Binary star systems are always cool.
Quickly, young cop, over here. We're all set for the rescue mission, but enemy forces seem to be aware of us already.
I'm ready. Let's do this quickly.
Affirmative. The controls are yours. You may now use the fusion orb inhibitor button to inhibit the fusion orb and shut down the ship's shields. And your remote control for that children's toy.
Grabbing Gary.
Yes. You may now press it to activate Grabbing Gary. And thereby the ship's boom arms.
Got it.
Alright, so the controls are exactly what they were before. That's Andy. Jeez. Look how fast this one is.
Wait for it.
Aw, oh, so close.
See the creature.
Sorry, Mirror.
See the creature in your mind's eye, then simply release.
I'm trying. Aw.
Dang.
It's a good
That's
thing.
Okay. Try again.
There's no consequence for failure.
Well done. Now the next one.
Man, the background looks like a polygon website.
Don't worry, she won't detect our moving the ship. I've covered our tracks very well.
Does that thing want to be rescued?
Okay, that's all we can do. We're pulling out.
No, I need to save this last one.
Don't make the same mistake you did last time, boy.
You said you trusted my instincts, right?
I don't understand. What is it about this creature?
I don't know, but it's important.
We've saved more than enough. It's just one creature. It's not worth the risk, boy. There is no need for this.
Oh, went too far. Aw, what? I totally had it.
Saved more than enough.
I got robbed. Yeah, I didn't have it that time. There we go. Well, it smiled, so I guess.
Got her.
I guess that's good.
Huh? What's that?
I have no idea. Evasive maneuvers!
Attention, ship is under attack.
I can't see her anymore.
Forget about the creature. We need to move you to a safe location. Come with me. Merrick! Run, Shay! Get somewhere safe!
Attention! Critical breach in outer hull.
I can fix this.
No!
Shay, there you are. Something's happened to the ship, but don't worry. Your father's gone out to fix it. Shay, where are you going? It's not safe! Shay!
Alright. And that is the end of Shay's story for now. But we still have a whole other half of the story to do. I love Villa's story so much.
Guess it's time to face the cupcakes.
But I'm not going to do it this time. I might do it later on once Act 2 is out. Really, all I've done is a quarter of the game. Because there's this act, or there's this half of the story, which is longer than Shay's half, I think. And then the whole Act 2, which is coming in April, they said, but hopefully that'll actually be the case. So I hope you enjoyed. I know it's a little more low-key than the usual stream, but I have fun going through that again. So stay tuned, and I will switch over to Spelunky. We have half an hour until the daily challenge, so I got one or two practice runs in. So see you in a couple minutes.